Welcome, all Rise and Shine violin students. This is Maya from 317 Maine, and I'm going to talk to you about how to unpack and pack up your violin to make sure it's safe and you're ready to play it. So here's my violin case over here. It looks very different than your violin cases that you have with you at home. But the important thing is there's a round, the top part of the case is nice and round, and that should always be facing up. So there's two ways that you can store your instrument. And that is either on its side with the handle facing up, standing tall like that, and then on its back with the round top facing up towards the ceiling. And one thing I reminded all my students when we were having in-person classes is that it's really important to find a safe and kind of not too hot, not too cold place to keep our instrument where nobody's going to bother it, because they're very fragile instruments and we want to just make sure we're taking good care of them when they're at home. So the first thing you'll do is unzip and unlatch your case and open the cover. When you're unlatching it, reminder again that the violin is on its back. So my case is open like this. Sometimes our cases will fall all the way open and be flat on the floor. You might have a cover on top of your instrument that protects it. That's okay, you just take it off and place it to the side. Then you're gonna unvelcro the violin and you're gonna hold it up and gently hold it by the neck and the body. That's just what we've practiced. And you'll have a sponge at home with some shoulder rest sponge. We have a sponge. I have a real shoulder rest, but I'll latch it on. And you'll put a sponge on with a rubber band that should be attached to the button of your violin right here. And you'll just take that shoulder rest and put it on and make sure that the tall part of the shoulder rest goes onto your shoulder, so it can kind of hook on. That means your violin is all ready. And then I put that back in the case. I'm gonna unlatch my bow. There's a little screw knob that you can unlatch. And you're gonna make sure that it's tight. You're gonna turn, there's a little knob, I'll just move closer, on your bow, on the end near the frog. And you can turn that clockwise to tighten it. And you want it to be about as tight as enough space for your little pinky fingernail to fit through it. And once it's tightened, that means you're ready to play. So the horsehair needs to be tightened and have a little bit of rosin in order to be ready to play. I'll show you rosin in a second. And when you're putting the bow away, you're going to loosen it by turning it counterclockwise. And you'll see that the hairs can move a little bit once you loosen it. And that's a nice way to store your bow, in order for it to not get warped. So I'm going to tighten mine again because I'll show you how to put on rosin. Rosin is a special substance made out of tree sap, just like maple syrup. Yours might come in a little box, and you're going to take that and you're going to gently rub it across the bow hair, which is our white hair made out of horse hair, very gently. I might do it 6 times back and forth all the way from the frog to the tip, making sure I'm not banging on the frog and metal part of my bow because that can break and chip the rosin. And that you need rosin, I would do that like once a week maybe. You need rosin in order for it to make a beautiful sound. So you put your rosin away in the little compartment, and when you're ready to put your violin away, you just loosen the bow here just like I demonstrated. Put your bow in the latch, tighten it. You're going to take your shoulder rest off, put your violin back, put your shoulder rest right next to your violin, latch up the violin, and then put a protective cloth on top and close your case and zip it, and then put it back in your safe spot. Thank you for watching.